Hey guys, today we'll discuss about the chest leads. So in ECG, we have two types of leads. One is chest leads and one is limb leads. So the major classification of leads and about the explanation of the leads, there is another video in my channel. You can go check that out. So today we'll be talking about chest leads. So chest leads are unipolar leads. They're unipolar leads, right? So that include V1 to V6, V1, V2, V3, V4, V5 and V6. So, how do we place the chest leads on a person? Here we have three lines. First I'll tell that. So here we have three lines, that is midclavicular line, the one is anterior axillary line and the midaxillary line. So this will be my anterior axillary line, here will be my midaxillary line and this will be my posterior axillary line. So we'll start from placing V1. So V1 is placed on the right side parasternal line in 4th intercostal space. V2 is placed exactly opposite in the 4th intercostal space in the left side. Let's not talk about V3 now. We'll come back to V3 later. We'll go to V4. So V4 is placed in a midclavicular line in the 5th intercostal space. And V5 in the midaxillary line. Anterior axillary line, V6 in the midaxillary line. So V3 is placed somewhere between V2 and V4. So this is a placement in a normal, like on a person. But when I compare the projection of these leads to the section of the heart, so it will be something like this. So here I'll have my V1 approximately, here I'll have my V2 approximately, V3, V4, V5. And V6. So whenever I'm telling a unipolar lead, they have only one terminal, that is positive terminal. So we will see how QRS complex changes in each and every lead, right? So first we'll talk, this is our right ventricle, this is our left ventricle, right? So here we have bundle of His that divided into two branches, that is left bundle branch and right bundle branch. Left bundle branch also have one anterior and one posterior division. But we should see between these two ventricles there is a septal tissue. This septal tissue is innervated by left bundle branch. So whenever left bundle branch is stimulated, septum will be depolarized. So see the innervation here, it is in this direction. See this. So whenever depolarization will start at this point and this will spread to the whole septal tissue. So whenever I am drawing the direction of the electricity in the septal tissue, it will be something like this, right? But we should know one property of the heart. Left ventricle is thicker than the right ventricle and the right ventricle contains more number of tissue. Whenever depolarization will spread, it will spread more towards the left ventricle because the left ventricle is more thicker than the right ventricle. So this will be the direction of flow in the ventricles, approximately something like this. So we will see how QRS complex changes will happen, right? So here I have drawn something. Let's consider these are the layers of the heart and here we have Purkinje fibers. So Purkinje fiber, this will be the endocardium, means it will start innervating from here to outside. So depolarization will start from inside to the outside. So if I turn this and if I keep it in this manner, you can understand this. Right. So we will see QRS complex changes in the all six leads. So we will start with V1. So I told all these are only positive terminals. So they are only unipolar leads. Right. Whenever electricity moves towards the positive, electricity moves towards this direction, it will show a positive deflection. Whenever it moves in opposite direction, it will show a negative deflection. Right. So we will draw how V1 looks like. So whenever depolarization happens, P wave will be there as usual. So whenever septum depolarizes first, it will be electricity will be in the direction of V1. So it will give a small positive deflection, right? A small R wave. Then the complete major ventricular depolarization is opposite from the V1. So that will give a deep S wave, right? So this will be the appearance of the V1. So when I take V2, V2 is also same. V2 will give normal regular P wave and it will have a positive R wave because electricity is something like towards the V2 and it will give more deepest wave, right? This will be the V2. Then we'll see V3 how it looks like. So V3, a part of it records septal tissue, a part of it records to a major ventricular depolarization, right? So it will have almost not equal magnitude but more positive R wave, I mean more bigger R wave when compared to V1 and V2. So V3 something looks like something like this, maybe more deepest wave. Right. When I take V4, so it is coming almost this way, so it will show a more bigger R wave. When I take V5, so V5 when I telling it is totally the major ventricular depolarization is there in the direction of V5. So V5 will have a large magnitude of R wave because the positive electricity will be there. So in some cases maybe Q wave is not recorded in V5 and V6. So that will give us a big R wave. Right. When I'm talking about V6, it is also in the same direction of major ventricular depolarization because electricity is moving towards the lead. So here it will give big positive R wave. So this is how normal ECG of a person looks on a chest lead. So keep following, guys. Thank you. If you haven't watched what is lead, how they are connected, please check out my other video. Thank you.